name is Matthew Gill, and we're going to be continuing this segment from where we left off last time. But this time I'm going to be talking about home life. And the next segment I'm going to be talking about school life. Please note, this is not to demonize anybody. I'm going to be telling you actual facts that happened based on personal experience. Then later on, down the road in life, finding out why it happened. Now, this is Walking with the Dark Past Towards a Brighter Future, Segment 2, Home Life. Months later, as things started to die down, we actually got to go back home to my parents. All of us. And by all of us, I mean me, Dina, and Laura. The rest were still with my dad. Once we were all reunited again, we decided, by we, I mean my parents, decided to start a new life. So we moved to Oswego. And were enrolled in Oswego school. But things were not bad, but they could have been better. At the age of 6, I got to know my diagnosis. I was diagnosed with bipolar C, ADHD, detachment disorder. Living with that is hell, which I'll cover in another segment called Med Change / Living with Mental Illness. As kids, we were close. You couldn't separate us. If you messed with one of us, you'd mess with all the rest of us. But we moved constantly. We stayed in Oswego, but we moved a lot. Because the landlords were not too break with us. They weren't too fair. In one of the houses we moved into, I remember this as pure as day, my sister and my mom got into it. From the corner of my eye, I seen my sister Carrie run towards the banister. My mom was right behind her, with a knife in her hand. I watched in horror as a boy, as my mom raised her arm, the arm wielding the knife, as if she was going to stab my sister. My dad comes in and grabs her arm, and she drops the knife. At that time, I didn't understand. It scared me. But later on in life, when I was able to understand, my mom went through a lot of med changes. And by a lot, I mean a lot. With some medicines that she took, it increased hostility. Am I saying I hate my mom? Absolutely not. Am I judging her based on her action? Absolutely not. Am I demonizing her? Absolutely not. I'm telling you what I've seen personally. My sister Dina was still a toddler at this time when this happened. But I've seen it happen. This next event. My mom went through another medicine change. And yet again, more hostility came out. She picked up this couch like it was nothing and flipped it. And nearly landed on my sister. It missed her, but it came close to hitting her. I remember seeing that. This one time, my mom put a chain and a padlock around the fridge. My dad went somewhere. Can't remember. And I don't know how long they were gone. I forgot all about that. None of us could get into the fridge. I'm not saying there wasn't food out, because there was stuff in the pantry. But when we got tired of that, we snuck up into my parents' room and got into my mom's personal stash. We were kids, and we got in trouble for it. The most I stole from my mom whenever I was a kid, it was me and my sister, Dina, and Laura. We were young, very young. The most we stole from her was $50. Yeah, we got in trouble for that, too. At the age of 9, I started bodybuilding. And I still do it. The reason why I started at such an early age is because I got tired of being bullied. And you see, the people I went to school with, some of them thought I did just to show off. Or look like this mean person would look intimidating. Home life was hell. So, when I went to school, I didn't take crap from anyone. Weightlifting kept me from wanting to hurt other people. Newsflash, I'm a teddy bear. I lift about 6 hours every other day. Yeah, back then I was cocky with it. That's to mask what I really felt. See, I always masked what I felt because I didn't want it to be used as a weakness. I didn't want to give anybody any ammo to use on me. Newsflash. I'm not an idiot.